Welcome. In this video, I will show you how to use React Bootstrap Carousels. So, we will implement the similar carousel in our application. We have simple application without nothing, and it was created with Create React app. So, the code of this application and the tutorial you can find in my GitHub. Link will be under the video in the description. So let's start it. First of all, we need to install Bootstrap and React Bootstrap. As you see, simple command. Let's copy it and in our repository, I'm working in the client folder, yarn add React Bootstrap and Bootstrap. I use yarn as my main package manager. Then you can check does it work or not by importing the button and check does it work or not. So let's try. First of all, we will open packages to check package.json to check do we have it. We have Bootstrap. Now inside our application JS, we can import Bootstrap from React Bootstrap button. We will import button component and let's try. Click me. The next important part is styles. As you see, for style sheets, we need import Bootstrap min CSS. It's important and crucial one. Don't forget import it. And now we have button, let's check how it works. So, and as you see now, button is with styles. Okay, we have button, everything works fine. The next step, what we need create carousel. Let's go to the components, carousel, and we have code sample. Let's copy it and try to implement a new component. I will create a new component, slider.js will be, and let's copy and paste this code. Then we will rename this function to slider, and don't forget export default slider. Now we don't pass any props, just import carousel from React Bootstrap carousel and code from the sample. As you see, we have carousel and we have carousel items is slides. We have three slides. Now in our app.js, let's import slider from slider, and now we can replace this code with our slider. Okay, let's check what do we have. As you see, it doesn't work as we expect because we don't have proper images. Refresh. As you see on the code sample, we had these broken images. Let's put some images. I have mock JSON file with images. We will use this file as props for slider, for carousel. Let's copy images. You can use your own images according to your task, but for now we will use this for the demo purpose. Okay, we have three of them. And the last one, so that's it. Let's check our page. We can refresh, and as you see, now it works better. We have images. We have arrows, we have buttons, and we have captions. title, subtitle. So as you see, everything works out of the box. Pretty simple one. So the next what I want to do, it's a bit customizing and implementing the slider in a proper way. So what do we need to do? First of all, I want to pass some props. It will be slides. And inside our carousel, we will use slides map. It will be array of data, slide. And let's copy item. Now we will remove these two. Inside, let's put, don't forget to put key. It will be slide image, as we have unique images. Then we have title and subtitle. Let's put slide title and slide subtitle. Okay, and now we need to pass these slides to the component where we will take these slides. As I said, we have mock JSON. Let's import mock JSON and we will pass these slides as props. Okay. Let's refresh, and as you see, we have avatar, we have description. But images are wrong. Let's check. We forgot to replace image. Source will be slide image. Okay, and as you see, now it works as we expected with all the information. The next, let's check our documentation and the latest one. As you see, also we have controlled state of the carousel where we can use where we can control the slides, how it should behave. As you see, we have on select function. So let's re-implement this behavior. As you see, it's pretty simple. We will copy use state import inside our slider. Then we need two props, it's active index and on select. And we need these functions, this code sample. Okay, and let's console log selected index. Selected index just to check what do we have. Now inside the application, let's click inspect console. Refresh the page. And as you see, when we change the item, we see selected index and we can manage it as well. Okay, also as you see, it's pretty responsible and swipes doesn't work right now, but if you enable mobile view, as you see, swipes works. You can swipe images as you need. The other problem is with this title and subtitle, but you can easily customize it. Okay, let's do the next. How can we change this information? This UI arrows and buttons. We can check from the documentation also that we can enable disable fade behavior. We can transition animation disable. Everything is described, implemented using different props. We can also set individual item intervals. For this item we can pass interval. So in case you need set interval, you can use for example but it should be number, not a string. And inside our slider we can for carousel item set interval, slide interval. Okay, don't forget commas. And now we will have these intervals. As you see, Black Adam was shifted faster. Okay, the next what I want to show you is customizing these buttons. It's pretty easy. As you see, all these buttons have styles, class names, and you can easily customize them. Let's, for example, create a new slider CSS file, and inside we will customize styles we need. For example, I want to use carousel. Then I want carousel indicators and I want change for example button. So let's set width 20 pixels, height 20 pixels and the border radius 50%. Then we need to import this CSS. Inside slider we will import slider CSS, and as you see buttons were changed. Now we have circles. The same with arrows, in case you need to change arrow. As you see, we have components. We have tags for arrows. It's for previous and next. Also, in the documentation, you can find the next icon props. And you can override this button. For example, you can set for the carousel, let's put next icon. You won't use the same span but with another class name, like with changed. And now you can in the code click inspect and you see that we have a new span with the class changed. And let's change style for this one. Carousel. And for changed, let's set background image. Background image. Another one. It will be URL. I have my new arrow. It's SVG. Downloaded from Font Awesome. Arrow. Right solid. And as you see, we have another button. So if you need to change the style of this button, you can check it's SVG, and for SVG we need to change some style. So you can play with customizing CSS, but in general it should be pretty easy. And as you see, we implemented this slider almost out of the box with super simple customization. The same you can implement for the title and subtitle in case you need responsiveness. As you see, we have all the classes available out of the box, and you can override styles as much as you need. So all the code you can find on the GitHub repository. The link will be under the description, under the video, as I said before. So thank you for watching.